A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about an important topic in biochemistry, that is uses of enzymes. It includes four headings. The first one is the an important one, that is diagnostic uses. Diagnostic uses of enzyme. It is an important LAQ for university exam. Then second one is the therapeutic uses of enzyme. It is again it is a important short note, or it is a part of LAQ. Then third one is the laboratory uses of enzyme, and fourth one is the industrial uses. So these three, diagnostic, therapeutic and laboratory uses, it is important topic for university examination. Also it is important topic for MCQs, short note and LAQs. So it is a very very important topic in biochemistry and must read. Okay, in this topic, these enzymes are divided into two main groups. The first one is the plasma specific or plasma functional enzymes. The concentration of these enzymes are more. Concentration, it is more in plasma, and they are functional in the plasma. For example, clotting factors, they are functional in the plasma. Another example is lipoprotein lipase. It is important in the plasma, and their concentration in cell is negligible. They are known as plasma functional enzyme. This group of enzyme, it is not useful in the diagnostic uses of enzyme. The another group of enzymes which is very very important, that is plasma non-functional, plasma non-specific or non-functional group. It is important. The concentration of these enzymes in plasma is low in plasma. They are non-functional in plasma, non-functional. Their concentration in cell is important. They are present in cell in low concentration. But remember this, they are present in cell in low concentration, but it is higher than the plasma. But whenever there is proliferation, necrosis, damage, neoplasm of the cell, remember this, whenever there is proliferation, necrosis, neoplasm or damage to the cell, concentration of these enzyme increases and they leak out in the plasma, and their concentration in plasma or serum now increases. Whenever there is damage, proliferation, neoplasm, necrosis of the cell, the concentration increases, they leak out of the cell, their concentration in plasma increases. And now these enzymes, they are used for diagnosis of various diseases. And they are used in the diagnosis. This is known as diagnostic importance of enzyme. This topic also includes isoenzymes. For more detailed information of isoenzyme, please watch isoenzyme topic on YouTube. Now coming to the diagnostic uses of enzymes. There are many enzymes which are used in the diagnosis of various diseases. If you go organ wise, it is very easy to remember the diagnostic uses of enzymes. The first and important one is the liver disease. The enzymes which are useful for diagnosis of liver diseases. Remember this, AST, the another name for AST is SGOT. Aspartate transaminase or serum glutamate oxaloacetate transaminase. Then ALT, alanine transaminase or serum glutamate pyruvate transaminase, SGPT. Third one is the alkaline phosphatase. Fifth one is the 5' nucleotidase and GGT, gamma glutamate transferase or gamma glutamate transpeptidase. These are the important enzyme for diagnosis of liver diseases. Also LDH, LDH 4 and 5 isoenzyme. Now this one, ALT, it is more specific for liver disease, specific as compared to AST. Because concentration of this ALT, it increases only in liver diseases. That's why it is more specific for liver diseases, ALT, as compared to AST. The ratio of AST and ALT, it is important. If it is less than 1, it indicates liver disease. And if it is more than 2, it is suggestive of alcoholic liver disease. And if it is more than 3, it indicates if the ratio is more than 3, AST-ALT ratio is more than 3, it is indicative of alcoholic liver disease. In cirrhosis of liver, it is nearer to the 1. AST-ALT ratio, it is important in the diagnosis of alcoholic liver disease. The concentration of ALT increases tremendously. Marked elevation of ALT and AST level, it is in viral hepatitis. Viral hepatitis. In this condition, the level of ALT and AST increases. It can be up to 2000, 3000, 5000 in these diseases. It increases, there is marked elevation in ALT, AST in viral hepatitis. Now coming to the alkaline phosphatase. It is a marker of obstructive liver disease. Obstructive liver diseases. These three enzymes, ALP, 5' nucleotidase and gamma glutamyl transpeptidase, they indicate obstructive liver pathology. There is increase in 2 to 3 times of the normal of ALP. It is in viral hepatitis, means hepatic diseases, viral hepatitis, 2 to 3 times. But it is up to 10 to 12 times in obstructive liver pathology, obstructive liver diseases. But it is more than 25 times of the normal in the malignancy, tumor or Paget's disease of bone. It is more than 25 when there is bone involvement, rickets, Paget's disease of bone, neoplasm, metastasis in the bone. In this condition, there is more than 25 times of the norm. So you may get a case in university exam on viral hepatitis or hepatic jaundice and obstructive liver diseases. So in obstructive jaundice, the ALP level is much more times increased, that is 10 to 12 times increased than the normal as compared to ALT and AST. ALT, AST level, it is slightly increase in obstructive liver pathology, but there is marked increase in hepatic diseases. ALP level, marked increase in obstructive liver diseases, and along with AST, ALT, there is slight increase in ALT, AST. So this is the scenario. If AST and ALT level or SGPT, SGOT, SGPT level, it is slight increase. Slight increase in this, and there is marked increase in alkaline phosphatase level, it indicates obstructive pathology, obstructive jaundice. And if there is marked increase in this ALT, AST and slight increase in the alkaline phosphatase level, it indicates the hepatitis. Got it? So these are the important enzymes, the LDH4 and 5 level isoenzyme, LDH4 and 5, their level increases in liver disease. So these are the important enzymes, their level increases in liver diseases. Now coming to the second important organ, that is heart. They are also known as cardiac markers. Cardiac markers. So second important group, it is cardiac markers. So the enzyme includes CPK, creatine phosphokinase, MB isoenzyme. This is important in diagnosis of myocardial infarction. Myocardial infarction. Okay. This is the earliest enzyme to rise in myocardial infarction. It is started rising in 4 to 6 hours after the attack, reaches peak in 24 hours and return to normal in 2 to 3 days. It is also a marker of reinfarction. CPKMB. Other markers are there in cardiac markers, but this is an enzymatic marker. Other enzymes which includes, second one is the LDH1. It is specific for heart. CPKMB is also specific for heart. Third one is the SGOT. It is not in use. It is late and non-specific marker. Other markers are there, that is myoglobin, then troponin T, troponin R. Then newer markers are there, that is other markers that includes myoglobin, troponins. Then newer markers include ischemia, modified albumin, glycogen phosphorylase. BB isoenzyme. Next one is the pregnancy associated plasma protein A, which is also a marker for myocardial infarction. So these are the important enzymatic markers. These are the proteins CPKMB, LDH1 and SGOT. Now coming to the third, that is pancreatic diseases. Markers for pancreatic diseases are enzymes which levels increases in pancreatic diseases. Third one is the pancreatic diseases. The first one is the amylase. It is important marker in pancreatic diseases, but it is non-specific because the concentration of amylase also increases in parotitis. There are two types of amylase, salivary and pancreatic amylase. So salivary gland infection also leads to the increase in the amylase level. Also abdominal condition, various tumors, neoplasm, perforation, there is increase in the amylase level. The more specific is the lipase. More specific. This is MCQ as compared to amylase. Lipase is specific for pancreatic disease. The next one is the bone diseases. Bone diseases. The alkaline phosphatase level, it is indicative of osteoblastic activity, alkaline phosphatase, then calcitonin, then alkaline phosphatase bone isoenzyme. It is important in the diagnosis of bone diseases. Alkaline phosphatase bone isoenzyme, that is pre-beta. There are six isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase. Alpha 1, alpha 2 hit labile, alpha 2 hit stable, then pre beta, gamma and leukocyte alkaline phosphatase. There are also other variants are there, that is Regan isoenzyme, then Nagao isoenzyme and Kasahara. These are the variants of alkaline phosphatase. So pre beta, the concentration is about 50% of total alkaline phosphatase activity. The activity increases in bone diseases. There are 6 isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase, that is alpha 1, alpha 2 heat labile, alpha 2 heat stable, pre beta, gamma, and leukocyte alkaline phosphatase. So these are the 6 isoenzymes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is indicative of biliary pathology. Heat labile, it is liver, it is placenta, placental origin. Then this is from bone, this is intestine, and this is from leukocyte. So these are the 6 isoenzyme. The concentration of bone isoenzyme pre beta, it is increases in the bone diseases pre beta. Then there are variants, they are known as Nagao. It is a germ cell variant, N germ cell variant. The shows inappropriate expression in malignancy. Then important one is the Nagao Kasahara. It is fetal intestinal variant. Fetal intestinal variant. And the important one is the Regan. Regan isoenzyme, it is the placental variant. Heat stable, it is similar to the heat stable. It is placental variant. Its concentration increases in carcinoma of liver and gut. Carcinoma of liver, lung and gut, there is increase in the Regan isoenzyme. It is similar to the placental variant. So these are the isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase. The level of ALP, it is increases in bone diseases. So these are the important markers in various diseases. Or in short, you can say about the diagnostic uses of enzymes. Okay. So summarizing all, the AST, ALT, alkaline phosphatase, acid phosphatase, then amylase, then lipase, CKMB, LDH. These are the important enzymes. AST, ALT, alkaline phosphatase. This includes, this level of this AST, ALT increases in hepatitis, alkaline phosphatase, obstructive pathology, acid phosphatase in prostate cancer. Also, there is another prostate cancer, and there is one antigen, that is prostatic specific antigen. The level of this increases in benign hypertrophy of prostate and also in prostatic cancer. Amylase, pancreatitis, lipase, these are the two increases in pancreatitis. CKMB, it is in heart disease, that is myocardial infarction. LDH1, it is increases in myocardial infarction. LDH4-5, it is increases in liver diseases. Also in muscle diseases. In muscle diseases, there is increase in CKMM fraction, muscle injury. Muscle diseases, CKMM fraction, it increases. Then also LDH5, it increases in muscle diseases. Okay, so these are the different enzymes. The concentration of these enzymes increases in various diseases, and they are useful in the diagnosis of various diseases. Now coming to the next, that is therapeutic uses. Therapeutic uses, it is very easy to remember. Remember the asparaginase. What you have to remember? Asparaginase. Asparaginase. So there are different enzymes and they have therapeutic use in our body. Coming to the asparaginase, the first one is the asparaginase. It is used in acute lymphoblastic leukemia. leukemias. Acute lymphoblastic leukemia, asparaginase. Okay. Then second one is the streptokinase urokinase. They are used in the clot lysis, lysis of the clot. They are thrombolytic agent. They are used in the myocardial infarction, cerebral infarction, then deep venous thrombosis. They are used cerebrovascular episodes. They are used streptokinase, urokinase for lysis of the clot. Then P for papain. It is anti-inflammatory agent. Okay. Then again A, that is first A is for asparaginase and second one is alpha 1 antitrypsin. It is used in emphysema, in alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, emphysema. It is used in obstructive airway disease, that is emphysema. Then R, recombinant tissue plasminogen activator. It is used for the lysis of clot in MI, also in cerebrovascular episode or stroke. Okay. So this is A for asparaginase, A for antitrypsin, S for streptokinase, S for streptodornase is also there, which is DNase enzyme. And it has local application, that is streptodornase. S for streptodornase. It is DNase enzyme. DNase, and it has local application. Then P for papain and P for, again there is one enzyme from this P. They are used in digestive disorders, digestive diseases. They are used in the digestive disorders. Then R for recombinant tissue plasminogen activator. It is used in MI and CVE. So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are the 8 enzymes and their therapeutic uses. Asparaginase, it has mechanism of action. It utilizes aspargine, and tumor cell uses aspargine as the substrate. So asparaginase utilizes aspargine, decreases the level of aspargine and inhibit the cell growth. That's why it is used in the acute lymphoblastic leukemia. So these are the therapeutic uses of enzymes. Now coming to the laboratory uses. In laboratory uses, it is very easy to remember. Remember your experiments. In your lab, you do glucose estimation. There is estimation of urea. Uric acid estimation is there. Okay. Then cholesterol estimation is there. Triglyceride estimation, triacylglycerol estimation is there in our laboratory. So for the estimation of glucose, we use hexokinase method. Hexokinase. Also GOD, POD, that is glucose oxidase, peroxidase. These are the enzymes they are used for the estimation of glucose. Urease, Berthelot method. Urease, it is used for estimation of urea. Uricase, used for estimation of uric acid. Cholesterol oxidase, peroxidase, that is cholesterol oxidase, peroxidase. They are used for the estimation of cholesterol. Then lipase, it is used for estimation of triacylglycerol or triglyceride. Then there is laboratory uses in ELISA, enzyme link immunosorbent assay. In ELISA we use horse radish peroxidase. We use alkaline phosphatase in ELISA. Then in recombinant DNA technology, rDNA technology, we use TAC polymerase, PCR. TAC polymerase in PCR. We use restriction endonuclease in recombinant DNA technology. There are number of enzymes we use in recombinant DNA technology. TAC polymerase, DNA polymerase, restriction endonuclease, nucleotidase, so ligase, DNA ligase, number of enzymes we use in the recombinant DNA technology. Restriction endonuclease in RFLP, restriction fragment length polymorphism. So these are the uses of our laboratory uses of enzymes. Laboratory uses of enzyme in diagnosis of diseases. Got it? Glucose oxidase, peroxidase in glucose estimation, hexokinase in glucose estimation, urease in urea estimation, uricase in uric acid estimation, cholesterol oxidase, peroxidase, lipase, horseradish peroxidase, alkaline phosphatase, TAC polymerase, restriction endonuclease. There are number of uses of enzymes in laboratory. So, by this, we conclude this topic, that is diagnostic, therapeutic and laboratory uses. Industrial uses, there are very few industrial uses and they are least important for in this here on this platform. That is renin. Then in the preparation of high fructose syrup, we use enzymes. Okay, various fermentation process, we use enzymes. So that's all. Keep watching. Thank you.